Salam Sejahtera and a very good day. Now we move on to the second topic of this course. In this topic, we will learn about the biology of sea turtles, its unique characteristics and life cycle, as well as the importance of this endangered species. What is sea turtles? Sea turtles are reptiles, so they are cold-blooded. They have scales on their body and lay shell eggs. They are ancient animals with fossil records date back 150 to 200 million years ago, when dinosaurs became extinct about 100 million years later. Turtles survive through their adaptation to marine environments and exist until today relatively unchanged. Physiological features that are common to all sea turtle species and which set them apart from other testudines are: sea turtles have non-retractile limbs, extensively roofed skulls, limbs converted to paddle-like flippers, and salt glands to excrete excess salt. Sea turtles breathe air and spend most of their life in the sea. Only female will come up to the beach to lay eggs. Their eyes are adapted for underwater vision. They have no external ears, no teeth, and their jaws modified into beaks. Unlike mammals, which mature and stop growing at a certain age, reptiles grow and mature in relation to the amount and quality of food available. Green turtle, on a global scale, sea turtles have undergone a considerable reduction in their biodiversity since their peak in the Cretaceous period. Of the five marine turtles families of the Cretaceous, only two are represented among the present-day turtle fauna. Today, seven species of sea turtles representing two families are recognized. An eighth species, the black turtle or the East Pacific green turtle, is recognized by some biologists, but morphological, biochemical, and genetic data published to date conflict with this view, and the black turtle is currently classified as belonging to Chelonia mydas. Out of the seven species, four species recorded to nest in Malaysia: the olive ridley, the hawksbill turtle, the leatherback turtle, and the green turtle. This is the current taxonomy for sea turtles. It consists of two families, the Dermochelidae and Chelonidae. The Dermochelidae are represented by one genus and a single species, which is the leatherback turtle. The Chelonidae, the hard-shell turtles, are represented by six species from five genera. Here are the conservation status of sea turtle species. The hawksbill turtle is considered as critically endangered, green turtle as endangered, the leatherback turtle as vulnerable. This conservation status was changed in 2013 from critically endangered to vulnerable because of the increase of the Atlantic leatherback populations. However, drastic reductions in the Pacific leatherback populations. The leatherback is considered extinct in Malaysia. The conservation status for loggerhead turtle is endangered, the olive ridley turtle as endangered, whereas the Kemp's ridley turtle as critically endangered. The flatback turtle is considered as data deficient because not enough information available to determine the status. As a consequence of their food and habitat requirements, adult sea turtles are unevenly distributed throughout the Sikkim global tropical and subtropical seas. While most species are widely distributed, camps really is restricted to the Gulf of Mexico, and the flatback turtle is endemic to the Australian continental shelf. Foraging occurs over a wide range and on the relatively shallow continental shelf areas. The present distribution of the breeding sites has been largely affected by historical patterns of human exploitation. The only substantial breeding colonies left today are those that have not been permanently inhabited by humans or have not been heavily exploited until recently. In Malaysia, breeding sites of sea turtles can be found in Sabah, Sarawak, Terengganu, Pahang, Johor, Malacca, Perak, and Penang. Being an ancient animal, sea turtles have unique characteristics. Even though sea turtles spend 99.9% of their life underwater, they breathe air, so they need to surface to get air. Failing to do so, sea turtles will drown. They have long maturation time, about 20 to 50 years. Because of this, they face high mortality rate. Sea turtles will return to breed only at the place where they were born, a term called natal homing. Apart from that, they also show nest site fidelity, coming to nest to the same beach over and over. This was proven by the long-term tagging program. For example, the tagging program by University Malaysia Terengganu at Redang Island. Sea turtles will lay several hundred eggs in one nesting season. They conduct long-distance breeding migrations between foraging and nesting grounds. They are long-lived animals and can live up to 100 years. Like other reptiles, the sex of hatchlings is dependent on temperature during incubation, particularly during the third or fourth weeks. Higher temperature will produce female, and cooler temperature will produce male hatchlings. All seven species of sea turtles reproduce on beaches around the world and share a common life cycle with minor variation. Once mature, about 20 to 50 years, sea turtles migrate from distant feeding grounds to different nesting areas. Once the males and females arrive, they mate for a period of 1 to 2 months. After mating, the males return to the foraging grounds, and the females take 2 to 4 weeks to emerge on the beach and lay the first clutch of eggs. The number of egg clutches laid during a breeding season varies within and between species. Female green turtles can lay up to 10 clutches in a breeding season with an interval of 9 to 14 days with mean clutch size of 100 eggs. Hatchlings will emerge after 2 months of egg incubation. There is no parental care of eggs or hatchlings. Incubation period, incubation success, and hatchling sex ratio is determined by nest temperature. Higher temperature will produce mainly female, and cooler temperature will produce male hatchlings. Upon emergence, hatchlings will crawl to the beach and will swim non-stop for 2 to 5 days, or known as swimming frenzy. They will be carried by ocean currents into oceanic pelagic habitats. While in the pelagic habitat, all species are carnivorous, feeding on a wide range of macro zooplankton. The hard-shell turtles remain in the oceanic environment for a few years before they return to coastal waters, where they change to a benthic feeding life history phase with diet varying with species. Nothing is known during the first 10 years of their life. Scientists call it the lost years. After some years of pelagic life, older juveniles of most species are thought to recruit to neritic habitats where they complete their development. Juvenile will shift from one foraging ground to another an adult will be a resident to a particular foraging ground. At the following reproductive season, they migrate back to the nesting area in 2 to 8 years interval. Sea turtles played an important role in maintaining the health of the world's oceans. They migrate thousands of kilometers and take decades to mature. Hence, it serves as an important indicator of health of coastal and marine environment on both local and global scales. These are the importance of sea turtles. First, maintaining habitat. The green turtles are herbivores, animals that eat seagrass. When green turtle graze, they increase the productivity and nutrient content of seagrass blades. The hawksbill turtle has a beak-like mouth, which enables them to forage on a variety of marine sponges. By doing this, they change the species composition and distributions of sponges in coral reef ecosystems. By removing sponges from reefs, hawksbills allow other species, such as coral, to colonize and grow. Without hawksbills, sponges are likely to dominate reef communities, further limiting the growth of corals and modifying the structure of coral reef ecosystems. Through the selective foraging behavior, hawksbill impact the overall diversity of reef communities. When female sea turtles lay their eggs on sandy beaches, they introduce nutrients and energy into the beaches. Sea turtle eggs that hatch return to the sea as hatchlings, leaving some nutrients on the beach in the form of eggshells and embryonic fluid. The eggs that fail to hatch are consumed by predators, for example, monitor lizards, ghost crabs, or the eggs are penetrated by roots, enabling plants to absorb the nutrients. Second importance, maintaining a balanced food web. Leatherbacks, the largest sea turtle species, get their energy and nutritional needs from a jellyfish. Because of its large size and migrating across entire oceans, leatherbacks rely on large concentrations of jellyfish. As significant consumers of jellyfish globally, leatherbacks play a pivotal ecological role as a top jellyfish predator. By carrying around barnacle, algae, and other similar organisms known as epibionts, sea turtles provide a food source for fishes and shrimp. And finally, sea turtles are important for tourism, education, and scientific research. In the end, we will conserve only what we love. We will love only what we understand. And we will understand only what we have been taught. Hopefully by now, you will understand why we need to protect and conserve sea turtles. Play your part now. Help save sea turtles from extinction. Thank you.